The hearing of Datuk Seri Najib Razak's final SRC International appeal will begin this Thursday after the federal court dismissed a bid by his new lawyers to adjourn proceedings. Chief Justice Tun Tengku Maimun Tuan Mat, who led the five-member bench, said Najib was well aware of the dates fixed for the hearing when he chose to discharge his former lawyers and appoint Messrs Zaid Ibrahim and Hisham Teh instead. She said that this is Najib's right to do so, but he cannot then turn around and say that his new lawyers are not ready to proceed with the hearing of the appeal. She pointed out that his new lawyers too are not entitled to say they need more time to prepare, knowing fully well that the dates have been fixed well in advance. Earlier, she had directed the hearing to proceed after dismissing the motion to adduce further evidence. But Najib's new lead counsel, Teh, asked the bench to allow the case to be deferred for 3 to 4 months, as the team needed time to go through all the files. The former Prime Minister and ex-Finance Minister was found guilty of abuse of power in relation to approving 4 billion ringgit in loans by Retirement Fund Inc. to SRC, and 3 counts each of criminal breach of trust and money laundering of 42 million ringgit of SRC funds. He was sentenced to 12 years jail and fined 210 million ringgit in August 2020 by the Kuala Lumpur High Court. Last December, the Court of Appeal upheld the convictions and sentences, resulting in this pivotal final appeal. Tan Sri Ahmad Ramli Mohd Noor, a former Navy chief and previously the MD of Boustead Naval Shipyard, BNS, pleaded not guilty to 3 counts of criminal breach of trust in connection with the Littoral Combat Ship Project. He was charged in the Kuala Lumpur Sessions Court under Section 409 of the Penal Code for approving payments to 3 companies amounting to 21.08 million ringgit between July 2010 and May 2011 without the requisite approval of the company's board. The first charge involves fraudulently approving a 13.54 million ringgit payment to Sataria Holding. The remaining 2 involve a 1.36 million ringgit payment to JSD Corp and 6.18 million ringgit to Submarine Armada. If convicted, he faces up to 20 years in jail, whipping and a fine. Judge Susanna Hussein set bail at 500,000 ringgit and fixed November 24th for mention. Ahmad Ramli's lawyer, Datuk Muhammad Yusof Zainal Abidin, said he will be sending a letter of representation to the Attorney General's chambers to review the charges. Back in 2011, BNS received a letter of award from the Defence Ministry to deliver 6 littoral combat ships. The Royal Malaysian Navy was to have received 5 ships by this month, but not a single vessel has been delivered yet, despite Putrajaya having spent 6 billion ringgit on the project. Bursa Malaysia-listed firms' combined market capitalisation rose 2.8% to 1.693 trillion ringgit last month from 1.648 trillion ringgit in June. Analysts at the Stock Exchange Operator and Regulator's research arm, Bursa Digital Research, said the increase was due to a broad market rebound in the second half of July. The monthly average daily volume, ADV, fell 29.3% from the previous month to 1.34 billion ringgit in July. On a year-to-date basis, 9 out of 10 of the lowest ADV were recorded in the month of July. On average, the ADV during these 9 days was 1.16 billion ringgit. July witnessed local retail investors turn net sellers for the first time this year, as they net sold a total of 16.03 million ringgit. According to the research firm, foreign investors were the only category of investors that saw a net inflow of 174.98 million ringgit. Local institutional investors resumed their selling in July, disposing of 40.87 million ringgit worth of holdings. On a year-to-date basis, foreign investors remained the biggest net buyers, accumulating securities worth 6.26 billion ringgit. Local retail investors net bought 1.70 billion ringgit in equities and sold a net of 7.95 billion ringgit worth of holdings. Duo Pharma Biotech posted a 6% increase in net profit for the second quarter of FY22, underpinned by higher revenue as it booked higher sales to the ethical classic market and public health sector. Earnings rose to 16.31 million ringgit, while revenue for the period jumped by 16.92% to 181.74 million ringgit. It declared a first interim dividend of 0.5 cent per share. For the cumulative 6 months ended June 30th, net profit rose by 10.9% to 36.6 million ringgit, while revenue was 14.23% higher at 367.68 million ringgit. Commenting on the group's financial performance, Duo Pharma Biotech Group MD Leonard Arif Abdul Shatta expressed confidence in the company's performance for the remaining months of the year, supported by the positive growth momentum seen in Malaysia's economy. Over the longer term, he said the group is always exploring new opportunities to expand its product portfolio and remains on the lookout for potential mergers and acquisitions within ASEAN to increase its earnings abroad. Shares in Duo Pharma closed 1.47% lower at RM1.34, giving it a market capitalization of RM1.28 billion. Apex Healthcare booked an 83.15% jump in net profit in the second quarter of FY22 to 23.5 million ringgit on improved operating profit from its subsidiaries, as well as a significantly stronger share of net of tax earnings from its associated company. The manufacturer of pharmaceuticals and consumer healthcare products announced that revenue rose 14.62% to 209.2 million ringgit, in line with rising business optimism and strong private sector sales in Malaysia and Singapore. It declared an interim single-tier dividend of 3 cents per share. As for the first half, earnings grew 58.9% to 39.26 million ringgit, while revenue grew 17.4% to 425.17 million ringgit. Apex Healthcare said demand for its products remained elevated because of the continued prevalence of COVID-19 infections, manifesting largely as a community respiratory illness, and will continue going into the second half, supported by growing private consumption as well as the possible emergence of new waves of COVID-19 infections. Barring unforeseen market changes and developments, the group expects to deliver another satisfactory performance in 2022 amid the challenging circumstances and is confident that its growth prospects are positive. Apex Healthcare shares finished up 1.31% at RM3.10, translating into a market capitalization of 1.48 billion ringgit.